Rugsėjo pradžioje Džonas Gilonas nusprendė pasirašyti sutartį su Pasvalio pieno žvaigždėmis ir pirmą kartą karjeroje turėjo palikti gimtinę bei persikelti į kitą Atlanto vandenyno pusę. Amerikietis gimė ir užaugo Hiustone, mieste, kuriame yra 2 milijonai gyventojų ir temperatūra retai per metus nukrenta žemiau 0 laipsnių ribos, todėl persikelti į 6 tūkstančius gyventojų turintį Pasvalį Gilonui buvo nemenkas iššūkis.
The weather is way different. It doesn't snow in Houston. I mean, it has before, maybe like once or twice, but it's really a hot weather city, so that's an adjustment. I mean, it's much bigger, like much more to do, so you know, it's an adjustment for me, but at the same time, a place like this helps me just to get my priorities straight and just focus on basketball.
Nusprendęs persikelti į Europą ir pradėti naują karjeros etapą, 25-erių gynėjas įvardino didžiausius sunkumus pirmaisiais mėnesiais Lietuvoje.
Probably just the language barrier. I've never been to Lithuania or ever even heard anybody talk about it, so just communication with other people is probably the hardest part, and that like trickles down to a lot of things like ordering food, telling people what you want or need, buying stuff from the store. I mean, they can't really understand you, so it's, you know, that's been an adjustment as well.
Prisitaikyti Gilonui reikėjo ne tik prie gyvenimo už aikštės ribų, bet ir prie kitokio žaidimo stiliaus Europoje, kur jis vis dar susiduria su anksčiau nematytais sunkumais.
Probably just the pace of the game. I'm still adjusting to this day on the pace, on where to attack. There's a lot more help defense. It's a lot slower than in America, so I'm just trying to adjust to that and, you know, be as productive as I can with the style of play.
Po pirmųjų poros rungtynių BCF LKL pirmenybėse įžaidėjas sunkiai susitaikė su kitokiu taisyklių traktavimu. Nors iš Teksaso kilęs krepšininkas ir dabar dažnai nesulaukia anksčiau įprastų buvusių teisėjų švilpukų, tačiau į tai Gilonas taip nebekreipė dėmesio kaip sezono starte.
Oh yeah, I don't get any calls at all, but it's okay. I'm learning to adjust through that as well. I got a lot of calls in the G League, but here I don't really get any, so I'm just having to play stronger and smarter.
1,83 m ūgio atletas Europoje pastebėjo ne tik taisyklių traktavimo skirtumus, bet ir visai kitokius žaidimo stiliaus akcentus.
In G League, I mean, you're playing against NBA players, you're playing against, you know, I think the biggest difference is just the athleticism. People are much more athletic in America, but the game style here is more disciplined because it's slower. So, you know, it's different. Like, it's harder to score here because the defense is more packed. You can stand in the paint and help. In the G League is much more space.
Nepaisant to, Gilonas žaidžia pirmąjį sezoną Europoje, amerikietis nuo sezono starto tapo vienu pieno žvaigždžių lyderiu ir LKL vidutiniškai per 29 minutes pelno po 14 taškų, atlieka po daugiau nei 4 rezultatyvius perdavimus ir renka po 12.1 naudingumo balo.
I just like to play hard. I like to be a winner. We've lost a few too many games, but we're trying to get that turned around. I mean, just by setting the tone in practice, by just going harder. And I mean, what I want to do is I see myself as a playmaker. Whatever the team needs me to do, that's what I want to do that night. When it comes to passing or scoring that night, whatever the defense gives me, that's what I'll take.
Lapkričio 30-ąją pasvaliečiai namuose įveikė Panevėžio Lietkabelį ir sugebėjo Lietuvos krepšinio lygoje iškovoti 4-ą pergalę bei pakilti iš turnyro lentelės dugno. Gilonas tiki, jo komanda turi daug potencialo kilti į viršų ir žino, ką labiausiai pieno žvaigždės turi pagerinti savo žaidime.
I think not finishing the game, because in pretty much all the games we've had the lead at one point and just lost it. Like tonight, we lost the lead, we were up 13. Actually, we were up 14 at the most, I think. We let them come back and take the lead from us. So just figuring out a way to, you know, manage the game a little better, I think that will serve us well going forward. Because we have enough power and players to win the games, but we just gotta finish.
Įžaidėjas Lietuvoje koncentruojasi į komandinius rezultatus, nors tiki, jog galėtų nuskinti ir individualius apdovanojimus.
I think just us being at the top of the standings. Yeah, I would definitely want to be top four, do something we haven't done. So all the teams that just beat us in the first 10 games, we need to come back and get a win against in the next few. And individually, I feel like I could do it. I could see myself on there if we, you know, win, but I mean, that's not where my focus is. Just winning games and, you know, playing as a team, I think that will serve us better than someone going after anything individually.
Kalbėdamas apie ateitį, Gilonas neslėpė, jog norėtų sugrįžti į Jungtinės Amerikos valstijas bei patekti į NBA, tačiau savo galimybes vertina realistiškai, todėl neatmeta žaidimo Europoje, kur norėtų išbandyti jėgas aukščiausiame lygyje.
I mean, I want to play in the NBA, but I mean, there's only so many spots, but if I do come back here, I definitely want to you know, play for a good team, Euro Cup, Euro League, something like that, that just is just a new challenge, you know what I mean? Like, I'm all about new challenges and progressing forward in my career, and I think just throughout my career, I've proven that I can play at a high level, so I just want to keep that up and keep on, you know, breaking down new barriers.